For me, it's really important to also show that these kind of connected technologies can do two things. One, they can be educational. I don't know how to make cocktails, even though when I have people over, they may appreciate me making one. And so the display here has the recipe and will show you how to do it. The second one is, you know, it's just really fun to see it happen. It's just really there for entertainment. And the third part is, for me, when you connect an object like this, two mixologists, two people that have the craft of cooking, like yesterday I had a conversation with Carl Krakow, when you bring together makers, essentially makers of cocktails, makers of food, with people in their everyday lives, you get a tremendous amount of interaction and value. And that's the same product, right? The same product. New people come in, new people add new cocktails. You start learning yourself. You can add to the product as well. And so you start to increase the value of the single object to something that becomes richer over time and more engaging over time. So I personally, these are five prototypes. The product is launching later in the year. But I personally really look forward to having this in my kitchen, because I'm going to learn how to make all these cocktails that when people ask me about it, I just look at them and I go. The next thing that we wanted to do is really express this notion of making, of building, and this notion of the future of making and building. And this is what the Alchemy Lounge is about. It's a little bit like a futuristic, faceted object. Bar that has landed here, and it will be landing in a lot of places. We are making it, it actually collapses or dismantles into a single container, and then we'll be shipping it to outdoor and indoor spaces where we'll give people the opportunity to experience it. It's a little bit of alchemy with this diamond shape, because what's happening when you put bottles in liquid, when you put bottles in orange juice, for example, or bubbles in alcohol, it changes the nature of the material. And it changes it, sometimes to great results. When you carbonate simple, straight out orange juice, for example, it loses its acidity. Same with apple juice. When you add alcohol when you add bubbles to an alcohol cocktail, it changes the nature of the mix, it changes how it tastes, it adds fizziness and just a new ingredient. So it's the new magical ingredient. And what people will do with it, we have no idea. We have 200 cocktails or so on the machine currently, but we imagine that people will do all kinds of interesting, creative, maker-like things with the product. And for me as a designer, that is probably the biggest satisfaction. To work on the product, to develop the technology, with a great company like sodastream, you have incredible engineers at sodastream, and then to just simply see where it goes, see how people interact with it, what they invent, how they become better at what they do, how to discover new things. This is where I think something like the sodastream mix machine is going to be really interesting, because you can develop a relationship with a chef, for example, with Carl Krakow, who can upload a cocktail to your machine. You can develop, you can make these kind of surprises happening on a product which usually would have been static in its use and in its experience. I think the mix, the sodastream mix, will be remembered as the first IoT, the first connected device, which has an entertaining value and is quite fun and something that you want to use over.
So there is a corresponding application on your phone which allows you to create your own cocktails and then upload them to your machine, and as people see them in this SodaStream app, if there's something they like in there, you can also upload your cocktail to my machine in San Francisco, which will be really fun. This is different because you essentially have to go look for information, find a cocktail, get inspired by the colors and the types of alcohols out there. So it's very much it's an interface which touch renders really, really easily. So in this case, I actually, if you talk to SodaStream, I am generally resistant to putting screens on things unless the experience is significantly improved and the experience is very adequate and matches the end result. You still need great recipes. As Carl Krakow was saying yesterday, he personally has 150 machines. That doesn't make him a chef less needed to operate them, to invent them, to so I think the sort of scary future where humans aren't needed and machines do everything for us. I don't think that's great. That kind of dystopia is great for Hollywood. It's great to sell movies, but it's certainly not what is truly happening. In this case, in fact, it will get a lot more people interested in cocktails, interested and able to.